Ladies and gentlemen, hey, hi, how you doing? Welcome back to the channel. Today we've got a lot going on in the world of Black Ops Cold War. Not only did we end up getting our first major update for the game with the 1.06 update, which is now live for all platforms, but earlier on this week, we also got a few leaks regarding some of the Season 1 content coming to the game in just a few weeks. So as we go over everything today, if you enjoy the video at any point, let me know by dropping a like on it. And, of course, if you're new to the channel, we are working towards 650,000 subs before the end of the year. So if you want to stay on top of really everything going on in COD, between Cold War, Modern Warfare, and then of course Warzone as well, this is the place to be, so feel free to subscribe and maybe even turn on those post notifications. Also, my friends over at G Fuel have actually bumped code IMMORTAL back up to 30% off. So if you want to get yourself one of my custom branded Immortal Shaker Cups, or really anything else on the site, now is a great time to do so. You know, sort of stock up for Season 1 and all that good stuff. But anyways, let's talk first about these Season 1 leaks because truly, there's not a ton here, but it does give us a glimpse into what we can expect in the future. As always with leaks, I will not be showing anything on screen for copyright reasons, but this info is courtesy of the Twitter account TalesDoll711, and it was reported on by Charlie Intel, so the info is out there if you do want to see it for yourself. But most of these leaks do pertain to the Battle Pass for Season 1, which, as we know, is going to be available for Cold War, Modern Warfare, and then Warzone 2, and you'll be able to progress the pass in any of those games all the same. So as far as some of the cosmetics go, we now know that we're going to be getting some new blueprint options with the Season 1 pass. Honestly, this is no surprise, but at the same time, I would much prefer to see some like universal camos become available rather than just one weapon specific camo that has some custom attachments. But nonetheless, we do know that blueprints will be back for the Season 1 pass. We also see we're going to be getting some new operator skins as well. The leaked ones were for Adler, which sort of feature him in like a trench coat outfit, very LA Noir-esque if you ask me. We also see some new weapon charms in the leaks as well. To be fair, really nothing too crazy here, mainly just some filler content ranging from photograph charms to grenade charms. Like I said, nothing too out of the ordinary there. Then we see that watches are going to be making a return this year as well via the Battle Pass. Obviously, this is something we saw a lot of back in Warzone and Modern Warfare. It seems to be another common filler item this year as well. So overall, we didn't see like a ton of major content, you know, but when it comes to the content we did learn about, we can basically confirm that the Battle Pass as a whole really is going to be largely the same as Modern Warfare, and likely the best content is probably going to be pushed through the shop to sort of increase MTX sales if I had to guess. Now, outside of the leaks, as I said earlier, today we also got the very first post-launch content title update for Cold War. This is available on PC and it's 5 gigs in size there. On Xbox, it's 11 gigs in size. Then on PlayStation, it's 3 gigs on the PS4 and then 6 gigs on the PS5. And this actually includes quite a few changes all across the board. So starting first with the changes, one major one they added in was a brand new setting, a familiar one if you've played Warzone and or Modern Warfare, and that is aim response curve type. And of course, this is just for controllers, but this is a super useful setting or was back in MW. It's back now with the options of standard, linear, and also dynamic. Now, standard is just a simple power curve, so you really wouldn't notice much difference if you were just using that compared to what we had before. Linear is then a one-to-one action from when you move your stick and what you see your screen do, and personally, I find this to be the best just because it is the most consistent. Then dynamic is a reverse S-curve mapping, so you have a varying response depending on how much you're actually moving your stick and how fast you're moving your stick as well. Also, on the main menu, they ended up adding in the locked gunfight tournament option, which indicates not only that gunfight is going to be back, which we know is coming in Season 1 for sure, but also the tournament system is returning as well, which overall should be pretty exciting. I always really enjoyed those back in Modern Warfare, so I'm glad to see those will be back too. Now, as far as the actual patch notes go, I'm just going to say it up front, there are an absolute ton of bug fixes in this patch. We're not going to go through all of them just because we would be here for like 25-30 minutes if we read every single one, so I'll have all the information on screen if you guys ever want to pause the video. But first and foremost, they actually created a brand new Trello board for Cold War just like we had back in Modern Warfare, so that's now available for everyone to see what they're actually working on for the future. But then getting into the weapon tuning, on the FFAR they increased the recoil, and then they also nerfed the max damage and the max range. On the MP5 they reduced the range, but this is actually bugged right now. This was essentially the nerf from earlier on in the week, but they ended up reverting it in this update somehow, but that will be fixed in the future. The MP5 will have its official nerf in the next update. Then on the M16, they ended up nerfing the range, the sprint to fire time, the move speed while shooting, the burst fire rate. Then they also rebalanced the fire rate barrels and reduced the effectiveness on the laser attachments. On the AUG, they did the exact same nerfs and rebalances as well. On the Type 63, they increased the fire rate and rebalanced the fire rate barrels, and same deal on the DMR-14. On the M60, they actually buffed the range and the movement speeds. On every single sniper, they nerfed the sprint to fire times apparently, which is a very, very weird change. Then they also fine-tuned the barrel attachments that improved idle sway. On the Magnum, they improved the fire rate, the range, and also the visibility after firing the first shot. Then finally on the shotguns, they reduced the damage in close range fights. So obviously, quite a few weapon changes were made, and surprisingly, a whole lot of nerfs went into effect here, especially like for the snipers. I don't really think that was necessary considering just how slow they are already, but the overall meta is already beginning to change quite a bit. Now for the modes, in hardcore, the friendly fire system now actually reflects damage after you get 3 team kills. In SND, they fixed a defusing bug. In FFA, they adjusted the spawns a bit. In CDL Hardpoint, they fixed a spawn issue. In Combined Arms, they improved the transition between the turrets. For general spawns, they adjusted various ones that result in bad spawns all around. Then in Custom Games, they added the score streak cost overrides. Then for the streaks, here they actually reduced the combat bow ammo. They increased the care package cost, lowered the sentry cost, increased the napalm cost, lowered the air patrol cost, increased the artillery cost, and then also increased the cost for the cruise missile and the war machine. For the attack helicopter, they increased the cost, they increased the damage and also the health, they decreased the screen shake from the bullet impacts, and they reduced the time it'll stay in just one place. For the VTOL, they reduced the cost and increased the burst length and reduced the cooldown time. And on the chopper gunner, they increased the cost and reduced the movement while actually shooting on the gunner itself. Treyarch also fixed an issue on Garrison with collision. Now you can actually throw tomahawks right as a round starts, so if you want to get those spawn throwing knives or tomahawks in SND, you can do so now. And they increased the time in which the EKIAs are actually going to count, so now if you dink somebody and they're alive for a little bit, you have a better chance of still getting that EKIA. They also improved the ability to trigger a finishing move, and they fixed an issue with posing while being finished. Now, there were also a ton of bug fixes in this update, as mentioned, and again, we're not going to go over every single one of them, but we'll have all of them up here on the screen. And here they fixed crashing issues for a handful of different situations, both in-game and then also relating to some streaks. They fixed an issue with challenge tracking, they fixed more crashes for equipment, field upgrade perks, and all sorts of stuff like that. They made some UI changes and fixes to prevent issues there regarding the gunsmith and just the general UI overall. Then in zombies, they fixed about 20,000 different things relating to perks, to the weapons, to progression not tracking correctly, to the HUD elements not appearing correctly. And again, in the interest of time, those are all on the screen if you really want to deep dive into those. Challenges resetting should also be fixed now in normal multiplayer. Camo showing as locked should no longer be an issue anymore, both in custom games and then also in pubs once you do actually unlock them. Progression display issues have also been fixed, and a handful of attachment issues were addressed as well. Finally, there were some PC-specific changes relating to settings not changing or displaying accurate information. They fixed the aspect ratio issues and some other smaller things as well. Also, today Treyarch actually revealed the official Nuketown 84 trailer. This sort of showcases what Nuketown is going to look like this year, and I just gotta say, I am all about this aesthetic. I think it looks really, really good, and this is actually going to be a free multiplayer map for everyone, and it's dropping next Tuesday on the 24th. You can also get the free Nuketown weapon bundle, which features a weapon blueprint, a charm, an emblem, a calling card, and finally, a sticker. But yeah, there you have it. With all of that being said, that is effectively what we now know about the Season 1 content for the Battle Pass, or at least some of it, and then also what changed today in the 1.06 update, and that is gonna wrap things up for today. If you guys enjoyed the video, let me know by dropping a like on it, and of course, if you're new here and you want to stay up to date with the latest Call of Duty news, intel, updates, and pretty much everything else in between, feel free to subscribe with your notifications turned on, that way you'll always know whenever I upload a new video. As always, if you want to check out any of my partners, be sure to use code IMMORTAL for a discount on all Scuf, G Fuel, and Control Freak products. Then also, as I mentioned in the intro, right now code IMMORTAL is actually 30% off on G Fuel, so if you want to grab a custom IMMORTAL G Fuel shaker cup or anything else from the site there, that and a link to everything else will be down in the description below. But once again, thanks so much for tuning in, and until next time, take it easy, have an awesome rest of your day, and I'll catch you guys later. Peace out.